Yeah, if you haven't watched part one of this video, I urge you to go back and watch part one where I was actually disseminating his first and second video on a non-absent parent. So we're going to continue on. Then I'm actually going to break down and show you the legal definitions and show you how actually far-fetched this guy is. And he definitely suffers from a severe case of aphasia. And more than likely, he's had a lobotomy.
Of my previous. So this is part three where we left off speaking that parents are only entitled to pay support to their child in their own household out of their own pocket, unless and until that parent has become an absent parent.
Proper interpretation of the term absent parent, again, is the parent that's not the primary custodian. And so both parents are obliged to pay and provide support for the child. And so since the one parent is not the primary custodian, primarily the father in most cases, then the father is generally paying support to the state or to the mother directly. Now, if he doesn't make payments to the mother directly, she would actually have to go and file a case. If she assigns it to where he has to pay through the state, now he's defaulting to pay the state, and the state is more prone to lock him up for contempt of court is what they use. Do I agree with this system? La'ah, meaning no, low. Well, but his interpretation of it is entirely incompetent.
Become an absent parent. Now, in the comment section of my previous videos, there are still women who believe, and surprisingly not that many, that this case is only trying to get men out of paying child support. Now, this is not based on my... Now, this is part four of a series where we left off speaking that no parent can become an absent parent if deprived of the custody of the child through no fault of his or her own.
Now, this is purely his interpretation of the law. So if we see on the screen, the legal definition of an absent parent is an absent parent is a parent who is not living with their child. This can happen when the parent gets divorced or separated. Or if one parent is not involved in the child's life, the absent parent is also called the non-custodian parent because they do not have custody of the child. The custodian parent is the one who lives with the child and takes care of them. It's important for children to have a relationship with both parents, even if they don't live together. A more thoughtful explanation, definition of an absent parent is a parent who does not have primary custody of the child. They may and may not have visitations right. The term is often used interchangeably with non-custodian parent. Example, John and Sarah are divorced and Sarah has primary custody of the child. John is an absent parent because he does not have primary custody of the child. Case closed. This guy is a complete idiot.
Because in doing so, actually relieves that parent from the legal duty of support. Now, this is not based on my opinions or belief, but based on the actual highlighted case law sitting on the screen, with one stating, whatever deprives the parent of the right to the custody and services of the child without fault on his part, relieves him from the duty to support.
Okay, so allow me to explain that because that may be causing some of you problems. So to be deprived of custody means total custody, right? Now, the father usually still has custody. He's just not the primary custodian. And that's what this is actually alluding to. Not that his custody and his parental rights has been totally diminished. A father still has rights, even if the mother has physical custody. He still has rights and say-so as far as the child's schooling and so on and so forth. So what this guy is teaching you is totally, utterly absent on. It's complete aphasia.
Now, when I began this series, I stated that this case proves that millions of non-absent parents are paying child support unconstitutionally. And a lot of people still may not understand what is a non-absent parent as it relates to Title 4D in the context that I am attempting to articulate it. So I believe these visualization charts will suffice. So
again, he's using the term non-absent parent. the level of incompetency here is insurmountable. But nevertheless, the non-absent parent, again, would be the primary custodian. That would mean the parent that the child is physically living with. To be clear, his misinterpretations of the law does not make it right. And just because he keeps reiterating, this is not my private interpretation, that's exactly what it is. And from an utterly incompetent standpoint, might I add.
So, when a mother or father decides to walk away from their legal duties and responsibilities to their child, they become an absent parent through the faults of their own free will and not the faults of anybody else. In turn, as you can see in the second slide, this now burdens the other parent.
That's an extreme play on words, because again, a man can be an absent parent by simply not living with his child, right? Yet he's still providing for the child, but he's still an absent parent because he's not physically living in the same household as the child. That's the proper interpretation of an absent parent in most cases. What he's using is the extreme case where the man totally pays nothing. He's abandoned it. And in such a case, he could literally lose parental rights if the mother goes down and file to have sole total custody. And so it's going to be at a judge's discretion whether or not he loses his parental rights, which most judges don't like to do. It has to be some extreme case. So let's be fair about this, man. Even though I don't agree with this system, this guy's fabricating stories to have a lot of people disappointed.
He now has all of the time, and the other parent refuses to render a proper financial support in that parent's absence. So because of this, parent B goes down to the state welfare office to seek state assistance from the taxpayer because parent A refuses to exercise his or her share of the custody and refuses to render a proper financial support in their absence. This is why Title 4D was created, to reduce dependency on the welfare rolls caused by absent parents. With that said, it cannot be the intent of Title 4D for a parent to deprive the other parent of the custody of the child and then cry foul to the state as one needing of monthly support. We learned in the beginning of this video that that would actually go against natural law. So what this case proves is exactly what I stated, that millions of non-absent parents are paying child support unconstitutionally. And it also proves that no court or agency ever asks, are you an absent parent?
Suffice to say, what he's proven here is that he's incompetent. Again, an absent parent refers to a non-custodian parent who is obligated to pay parental child support and who is physically absent from the child's home. The term also refers to a parent who has abandoned his or her child and failed to maintain contact with the child, the second case being the extreme. How can an absent parent's legal rights be terminated? In order to terminate an absent parent's legal rights over a child, an individual, usually a child's parent, present parent, will need to file a petition to terminate the absent parent's parental rights over the child in the local family court. A judge will review the material submitted, analyze the facts of the case, and determine whether or not the absent parent's legal rights of the child will be terminated or not. So this is actually determined by acting in a manner that would actually demonstrate the absent parent was unfit to raise the child, something like substance abuse and so on and so forth. So abandoning the child in some ways that which would happen to be one of the most cited reasons for filing the petition to terminate the parent's parental rights. So in most cases, this is not rewarded. It's an extreme case. This guy is setting a lot of people up for disappointment and failure. Stop listening to these jailhouse attorneys. Tune in to Kahan Tazadaq on YouTube for the truth. Thank you for listening, watching, like, share, and subscribe. And visit www.kahantazadaq.net. Thank you. If you have an issue with child support, child custody, get my book, Red Pill, White Knowledge. Shalom. Shalom. Bless up.